we're asked to simplify the cube root of 8a squared b to the fifth c to the third power. Now, the easiest way to simplify a cubic radical like this, where we have to find the cube root, is to factor this expression inside the radical into things that are perfect cubes and things that aren't. And the things that are perfect cubes, we can just take the cube roots of those and then kind of take them out of the radical, and everything else we can leave under it. So first, let's just focus on the 8, figure out if it can be factored into a perfect cube, or if maybe it's a perfect cube itself. 8 is 2 times 4. 4 is 2 times 2. So 8 is 2 times 2 times 2. Or it's 2 to the third. 2 to the third is equal to 8. Or we could say that the cube root of 8 is equal to 2. So 8 is already a nice perfect cube. So let's worry about this other stuff over here. So let me rewrite the radical. I'll leave the 8 the way it is, because it's a nice perfect cube already. I'll leave the 8 the way it is. And then let me focus, well, a squared, I'm not going to really be able to factor that into kind of a to the third times something else. I mean, I could if I wanted to be really tricky, but I'll just leave it as a squared for now. Let me do that in a different color. So that's a squared. b to the fifth, I can write that as b to the third power times b squared. And that way I have a perfect cube here, and then I have something that's not. But this at least I can take the cube root of. And then c to the third, that's already a perfect cube. C to the third, the cube root of that is c, so times c to the third. And so we can rewrite this expression here, just reordering things a little bit. This is the same thing as the cube root of 8. That's the first term right there, times the cube root of b cubed, times the cube root of b cubed, times the cube root of c cubed. So far I've taken care of that term, and that term. And these are all the ones that I can actually take the cube root of, and then I can leave the other two under this larger cube root. So times the cube root of, we have our a squared here, and then our b squared. Our a squared, and then we have a b squared right here. Now, the cube root of 8 is 2. Cube root of b to the third is b. Let me do it in the same colors. Makes it more visually compelling. Cube root of c to the third is c. And then this you can't really simplify anymore. I mean, you could kind of play around with it, but it's about as simplified as you can get for this cubic radical, or this cube root radical, or this third root, depending on how you view it. So times the cube root of a squared b squared. And we're done.